Gideon Okeke recalls how a female filmmaker threatened to end his acting career, basically, according to him, for not playing their kind of politics. And now he's like doing, look at me now, you know.
Why did he say a female? He mentioned her name.
Really?
Yes, it was this lady, Mo Abudu.
Was it Mo?
Yes. He tagged
Did you see that?
I didn't see that.
Really?
Oh, really?
He said, like, from Tinsel. It was from Tinsel that she... Obviously, they had an issue, and he said, after Tinsel, because contract, you can't just kick the person out. Mm-hmm. After Tinsel, I don't want anyone 10 feet near this person that I own you, whatever, like, you're done. You're done in the industry and everything. And
okay, so I didn't even know it's Mo Abudu. Now that I'm knowing she's the one, well, okay, I have nothing to say about that, but I'm going to bring this back to myself. I think I've been in this situation as well. I'm not going to call the person's name, but, I mean, of course, I was on that particular platform and something... Things went south, right? And as far as I'm concerned, even till today, I don't see it as going south because anybody did anything bad. I think it was just a lack of communication between the people working for her and not being able to let her know what exactly is going on.
As in Mo?
No, not Mo. Somebody else. And, right. You know, when the whole thing came, and this lady is known for dragging people on Facebook, like, she has the words. So she would drag you, and people would start pitying you. So when I put out my own statement, and then she did hers, and people were like, oh, wow, she's really angry. You have to go and beg her. How would you survive in the industry? And blah, blah, blah. I'm like, excuse you? Like, how is she surviving in the industry? So maybe because Nigeria is so big. I think Nigeria has that advantage that you can actually stand on your feet and not allow yourself to be bullied. It's not like, I'm sorry now, it's not like a Ghana where you might feel like, okay, everybody knows everybody.
Yeah.
But Nigeria's entertainment industry is just so huge that you have different, if you want to use the word cabal or godfathers or godmothers.
I was going to say, like,
we have different in different angles. So if you're not in this clique and you jump to this clique, but it doesn't mean that you have to shit and where you work and all that, just be professional and do it. And also, you also get this attack, because I think I see Gideon as someone who doesn't try to kiss anybody's butt, like, he says it as it is, and I'm sure that will not go down well with a lot of people in the industry. So I like that he's succeeding even at saying the truth and calling everything BS as it is. That's what he does, and I like him for that.
I liked that he mentioned that's also, I was really taken aback that he didn't mention person's name, but I like that he mentioned her name, because she's quite, like, what's the word? For me, or personally, she's quite intimidating, if that makes sense. Like, she looks like somebody that you wouldn't really want to mess with, because...
Like Maleficent.
Yes. If you're going to give her a character, a Disney character, you give her that with the horns and everything.
Oh, my goodness.
And also, like, really, like, you know, she just seems very stiff and all that. Obviously, super influential. So I think I kind of appreciated the courage to be able to do that.
Yeah.
And still saying that, listen, not only have I done more Tinsel jobs, I've done other things, and I've even helped my friends and all of that type of stuff. I think for me, what I took out of the story is that truly, really, the person isn't God. And I think we all have people in our minds that I'm like, sometimes I find myself in relationships, not close relationships, but relationships where I feel like it's really toxic, but I have to stay because I'm hoping that we can be in a good relationship, because I assume in my mind that you're my plug to success or whatever. Mm-mm. And sometimes I get reminders really quickly. This is one of them, that, listen, you don't really need one person to get to that table.
You need people.
You need people. But and yourself, actually.
The one person cannot become God.
Yes. So I really like that he brought that up into the limelight.
I think for me, what I took away from this is nobody's an island, and you need to start listening to people regardless of how little you think they are, how small you think they are, how little you think their contributions may be. Sometimes in speaking their truth and even speaking in anger may just be all you need to hear to change your own perspective about things. But, you know, we have a lot of egoistic bosses and superiors and line managers that just walk up like, okay, my truth is the final truth, like, you don't have a say in any of it. So I like where Gideon came from, that he was speaking his truth, and they he was getting punished for speaking his truth too truthfully. I don't know if that makes sense, but feel free to say what you want, but at the same time, you need to be mindful of your industry. Tread carefully. Not everybody gets as lucky as Gideon Okeke. He's a bunch of talent. The guy is talented. He's good at what he does. So even if Mo Abudu doesn't want him, what are the other female directors now?
What's the Iroko lady's name?
Mary Njoku. Yeah, she'll probably want him. He fits into all the stuff. So not everybody gets that lucky. So that know when you're speaking your truth, do you have what to back it up?
Yeah.
If the feces finally touches the fan, would you be able to survive? Would you
I think what I would say is we just have to get to that point where we all understand how to pick our battles.
Like, yeah. I was also going
there
to
say, are things you shouldn't bother about, like, yeah, you know, and then there are times you know that this is a battle for me, even if I'm not fighting it for myself personally, it could help someone else coming in the industry.
I think people were even trying to demonize her a bit, and I don't think there's anything wrong. Okay, this is just me personally. When you hear people say, oh, this person didn't believe in me, this person didn't believe in me, I don't
there's
think
nothing
you can
wrong
ask
in not
yes
in
I don't think you can
me.
I don't believe in every
not
single
everybody
talent
has
that
to
I have
believe
met
in you.
The people that I've said, oh, I don't think you're, I don't really think you have it, and then they blow. Like, I don't think it's anything wrong not believing in people. And if you have a truth and you tell the truth despicably, and that backfires, and I say things, like, I don't think it's even a case of like that she's like you can demonize her in this situation. I don't think she's done anything wrong. She's a boss, and you've ticked
her
off.
She just reacted.
She's reacted. You then happen to use that as a means to trigger your motivation to succeed. Great, but I don't think there's a villain in the story.
Another thing, I didn't like the fact that it's coming up. Yeah, I don't like the fact that it's coming up 7 years later. Although he said
it before. Motivation.
I forgave, but I never forget or something like that. So that's okay. It's okay to forgive, but when you forgive, like, can we just forgive and move on? You don't have to forget.
That's what he said. So.
Yeah, don't forget, but don't put it out there. That means you.
There's lots of things you don't want people to do. You want people to say when they've had a fight. Even that comment was really interesting.
We need to go though.
But yeah, I don't know. It's okay to share things. I think it's not a bad.
Well, it's okay. I just hope 7 years later you won't come and share this.
If he does, it will motivate someone.